Top 5. The leader of Iran's Islamic Revolution has described the Islamic Republic's stability in the middle of an unstable region as a major achievement for the nation.
شاخص بسیار عمده و بزرگی برای ملت ایران بود. امروز اطراف ما کشورهایی که همسایگان ما هستند از شرق کشور و جنوب شرقی کشور تا شمال غربی کشور کشورها دچار ناامنی هستند. منطقه دچار ناامنی است. ملت ایران به حمد الله در طول سال یک امنیت پایدار رو تجربه کرد.
Ayatollah Khamenei made the remarks in his annual message on the occasion of the Persian New Year Nowruz. He praised the Iranian nation for the response to the U.S. president's insult to their country, with a massive turnout during the February 10 rallies marking the anniversary of the Islamic Revolution's victory.
با یک بی احترامی که از سوی رئیس جمهور آمریکا نسبت به جمهوری اسلامی ایران شد، مردم پرشور و با حمیت و غیرت در روز 22 بهمن پاسخ اون رو دادند.
The leader of Iran's Islamic Revolution was referring to Donald Trump's travel ban on several Muslim countries, including Iran. In his message, Ayatollah Khamenei named the Persian New Year as a year of resistance, economy, production, and job creation. He called for concerted efforts to implement the economy of resistance. Alexander Azadgan is senior geopolitical analyst and professor of strategic global management who joins us from Laguna Beach. Alexander Azadgan, first of all, Happy New Year. And Iran's leader has spoken, obviously. He has made a point about how Iran has remained a beacon of stability in a region that is really unstable all around. How do you think Iran has been able to achieve that?
Before I start, happy Nowruz to you too, Kaveh, and the rest of the wonderful Press TV team. I think Iran has been extremely successful in somewhat being very safe being an island of instability amid a very volatile and insecure region. Mostly because Iran has secured a very good relationship with its western neighbor, Iraq, where the majority of these threats would emanate from. Also, the security forces in the southeast province of Sistan and Balochistan have been extremely wonderful in implementing and enforcing border control in a region where the Saudi Wahhabis have a lot of influence and where they try to penetrate Iran in every which way possible. So I think the diligence of the security forces, the harmony between various security apparatus within Iran has achieved this amazing result in a region where it's extremely unsafe, and it will get more unsafe as time goes by, especially when U.S. is going to interfere more in the internal affairs of Syria, as we have been seeing in the past several days.
Well, in particular, if you want to take a close look at the way that Iran has played his role, you look at a country like Iraq. When it was plagued by these Daesh terrorists from the get-go, Iran was there to help Iraq with weapons, with what have you, by the invitation also of the Iraqi government to partake in security operations there. Same with Syria. And also, of course, on the other side of the border, we're looking at Afghanistan, where Iran has played a role against these terrorists or Daesh terrorists, yet it comes out being demonized by the West, in particular the U.S.
Of course, we should expect that. Back in the year 2001 to 2003, where Iran was extremely instrumental in helping the coalition forces and helping the Northern Alliance, for example, in Afghanistan, you had George Bush declare Iran as part of the axis of evil. So they will try to use Iran whenever possible. And then when it comes to thanking Iran or bringing Iran to their international community, they will renege on their promise, and they will once again be under the influence of the Israelis and the Saudis, who have been demonizing Iran for 40 years. So, but going back to your earlier point, to establish wonderful relations with Iraq is an achievement unto itself. This is the country that attacked Iran and was, incurring terrible damages on the Iranians during those 8 years of, of the sacred defense. So maintaining good relations with Iraq, I believe, is a huge, huge achievement. On the eastern side, with Afghanistan, you have a lot of Pakistani influence, unfortunately, with Afghanistan, and everybody knows who's behind the Pakistanis. It's the Saudis. So the same proxy wars are going to go on. Iran's the reaction to Mr. Trump is extremely important. In Iran, trying to shame Mr. Trump is extremely important, although personally, I think this is such an outrageous individual that is not going to be shamed easily. However, I think the Iranian leadership and the Iranian management cadre should continue with this kind of strategies in order to expose Mr. Trump's total lack of tact and diplomacy.
Pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much. Alexander Azadgan, Senior Geopolitical Analyst and Professor of Strategic Global Management from Laguna Beach.